it's Jessie V, and as bizarre as this sounds, today we're talking about Pop-Tarts. You guys know how much I love nostalgia videos, and I love to turn nostalgia into something creepy. I don't know why I'm doing waves right now, but I found so many dark and creepy things about Pop-Tarts, it's gonna blow your mind. Who knew that basically a toaster puff would turn into something scary? This just shows you how random my channel can get. But that's why we're all here, right? Before we get started, I have two very quick announcements to make. The first one is that we have three new schools that have started Yana groups, which is so amazing. The first one is Otis Elementary. Then we have Haven Middle School. And also Safe House for Women. So thank you guys so much for starting this amazing movement. You guys are making a change in this world. And the next announcement is that I restocked the fluffy rainbow narwhals. I don't always restock stuff because I like to have new stuff on the website, but you guys really, really requested these to come back. They're literally just a fluff ball of rainbow. They're so stuffed, and there's a narwhal horn and there's little eyes underneath there. Anyways, they're literally so cute. So if you would like one, the link is down below in the description. All right, so let's get into the Pop-Tarts because yes, believe it or not, there are creepy stories surrounding them. Let's first get into some weird facts and history, and then we definitely have some creepy pastas. The first fact is that there were only four Pop-Tart flavors when they first came out. Kellogg's first introduced Pop-Tarts in 1964. It was unfrosted and came with four flavors: apple currant jelly, strawberry, blueberry, and brown sugar cinnamon. And then in 1967, they came out with the frosted ones, which did way better. And today, there are over 30 kinds of Pop-Tarts that you can choose from. So you're bound to find one flavor that you will like. The chocolate ones are definitely my favorite. The next fact is that Pop-Tarts actually had a different name at the beginning. They were originally going to be called fruit scones instead of Pop-Tarts. I'm really glad they changed that. Kellogg's changed their mind last second and said that Pop-Tarts was influenced by Andy Warhol's pop art in the 1960s. So I think that pop art helped them to become more popular. I remember learning about pop art when I was in art school and I love it. So colorful, so bright. The next fact is so embarrassing for them. They accidentally ran out of Pop-Tarts in 1964. In 1964, the first shipment of Pop-Tarts sold out in just 2 weeks. So Kellogg's had to send out a message basically saying, oops. But soon after they were put back on the shelves, people were just so mad because they literally ran out of Pop-Tarts. And the last interesting fact is that they actually had a Pop-Tarts World in New York City. The Pop-Tarts World store opened its doors August 10th, 2010. The store was known for making Pop-Tart sushi and a light show that occurred every hour and a dessert menu to die for. So Pop-Tart World was basically where you ate Pop-Tarts and were also entertained by stuff. But I don't know, Pop-Tart sushi? Okay, let's get into one of their scandals. They had a huge recall in 2006. It's actually crazy what happened. Pop-Tarts accidentally put the Hot Fudge Sundae Pop-Tarts into the Blueberry Pop-Tarts box. And the concerning thing is the Sundae ones actually contained milk, and that's obviously not listed on the blueberry package, so it posed a very huge allergy concern because kids would get home, open their blueberry box, and eat the Sundae things that had milk in it, and if they were allergic, well, that's not good. I don't know how they messed up and put Sundaes into blueberries, but like, imagine getting home from the store and opening them, like, seriously? All right, so now let's get into the creepier side of Pop-Tarts. They are known for having some very disturbing commercials. Maybe some of you guys will remember these. Now, when Pop-Tart commercials first came out, they were super simple and happy and positive vibes. It showed kids smiling and eating their toaster treats. But then the commercials started to get a little bit more disturbing. The brand decided to create these animated Pop-Tarts that continuously got themselves into some very horrible situations that usually led to them being eaten or being in a hot toaster against their will. I think there was just something messed up about seeing food with a face and eyes and then seeing it being like destroyed. No one wants to see Pop-Tarts that are alive being sent to their doom. There was this particular commercial that really disturbed parents, and Kellogg's actually got a lot of complaints from this. It was one where animated Pop-Tarts are waiting to have their photo taken in a photo booth, but it's actually a toaster and they don't even realize it. So these two Pop-Tarts, they look so cute. They're just standing there waiting for their picture to be taken, and the photo booth they're in keeps getting hotter and hotter, and they start sweating and turning red. They don't really know what's happening to them. So obviously they're actually in a toaster about to be eaten. So you're literally just watching these animated Pop-Tarts go to their doom. There was this other commercial where these Pop-Tarts were running to jump into a pool, and they think they're going into the pool, but they actually jump into a toaster. So it's extremely dark, especially when the advertisements are more meant to be for kids. A lot of parents were saying that the commercials were so dark that it made them not want to buy Pop-Tarts anymore. I don't know if I'd go as far as saying that because I love Pop-Tarts. This actually reminds me of this creepy popcorn commercial that always plays before a movie starts at the theater. These commercials may only be in Canada because it's at Cineplex theaters, but it shows the popcorn having faces and talking. And every time I see this commercial, I second guess eating my popcorn because I feel bad for them. I don't want to see faces on my food. Like, after that commercial comes up on the screen, I just look down like, oh no, I can't eat you now. All right, let's get into a Pop-Tarts Mandela effect. There are so many people around the internet that are freaking out about the Pop-Tarts logo. Now, this has been the Pop-Tarts logo like the entire time since the very beginning, and people are saying that they do not remember that circle after the pop. There's basically a dot after the first word. People are saying it looks like it doesn't belong, like it was placed there randomly, and they don't remember that circle between the words when they were kids. So I want to know from you guys, because the whole Mandela effect is that we could all be from like different dimensions. So do you remember a circle on the Pop-Tarts logo, or do you remember it not being there? Because me personally, I don't remember that circle. Alright, let's get into a very scary Pop-Tarts creepypasta. This story is about a little girl who was convinced she had a monster in her closet. And I feel like that was something we all thought as a kid, like either in your closet or under your bed. Places that are super dark and that you can't really see, you just assume there's a monster there. So every night she would hear this shuffling sound in her closet. It was like something was moving around in there. And she would also hear what sounded like nails going down the back of her closet door, as if someone was standing there doing this with their nails. So she decided to tell her parents about what she had been hearing. But you know, most parents, they say, it's all in your imagination. But she knew deep down that it was something way more than that. So she decided to find out for herself. That night before she went to bed, she put a box of raspberry Pop-Tarts into her closet to see if it could be like bait for the monster. If she woke up and the box was eaten, she would know there's a monster in her closet. She really wanted to prove that something was there. So she went to bed anxiously waiting for the morning. And around 2 a.m., the shuffling started. But this time she heard what sounded like plastic crinkling. Was the monster eating the Pop-Tart she put in there? The next day, she opened the closet door to see an empty, crumpled up raspberry Pop-Tart box lying on the floor, and written on the wall at the back of her closet said,
"More, please."
So, it's kind of creepy. I feel like her parents would believe her now. And the last creepy thing we're gonna talk about is a very creepy Pop-Tarts review that someone made. As you can imagine, billions of Pop-Tarts are sold every year, so it's gonna be a lot of people who are reviewing them. Most people like them, but some people don't. There was this very strange review that was going around the internet that said, "Just tried the pumpkin pie Pop-Tarts yesterday. They definitely have a very strong flavor. They were good. I'd buy them again. Just wish the box would stop whispering to me." Excuse me? Everything sounded totally normal until the last sentence, and then you're like, wait, what? Did I read that right? What the heck is he talking about? I don't know, it's weird. I don't know if I should feel bad for him or afraid. Anyways, look guys, those are all of the creepy facts about Pop-Tarts I'm gonna be talking about today. Are you surprised at how much scary stuff I found? Because I kind of am. If you like this nostalgia series, definitely give this video a thumbs up. Comment down below what you want me to talk about next. And don't forget about the rainbow narwhals, and I will see you guys in my next video. Bye!